the entrance of the Pope apartment, Paul V. You can notice this because he wrote his name on every single door. Paul V, Paul V, Paul V, so it can't be wrong. Everything here was made in the 17th century, the ceiling, the tables, everything. Only the floor was renovated by Paul VI, 3 centuries later. On this wall, there are only popes that have a relationship with this church. For example, the first one on the left is Sisus V, the same pope that built the Sistine Chapel, not the one in the Vatican, because that one was built by Sisus IV, not the V. The other Sistine Chapel is in this church, is the last one on the right side. The second one on the top is Borgia, Alexander VI Borgia, from Spain. I'm going to talk about him in 1 minute. So, on this wall there are only popes, on the other walls cardinals. But these three here in the middle, they are the kings of Spain. They are here also because in 1494, so 2 years later the discovery of America, Isabel of Castilla decided to donate to the Pope of Borgia a huge amount of gold, the first gold imported from America. And the Pope decided to decorate the ceiling of the nave with those gold. So what you saw downstairs on the ceiling is not the gold painted. Those are all pieces of gold of the 1494. This is why this church has a strong relationship with the Spanish kings, because they made a lot of donations. For the V belonged to another family, the Borghese family, and the symbol were eagles and dragons. You can also see it in the middle of the ceiling. And Paul V also built the last chapel on the left side. I suggest you to visit the chapel, because that's where Pope Francis always goes to pray. There is a really ancient icon, the icon of the Virgin of this church. Pope Francis always goes there to pray. That means in front of the icon he goes away. The Pope already can hear exactly 59 times, so thank you every single time. This way. Okay, this one belongs to the Cardinal Scipione Borghese, Paul V mentioned, a metal silk handmade with the gold thread. This is an hymnal of the 15th century, and this is an ancient papyrus of the 5th century. It's in Greek. Someone translated in Greek the second letter by St. Peter. And there are only two of these, one here and the other one.